Right away, using the Eureka effect, I'm going to place down all three buildings in front of spawn. A teleporter entrance in the middle, a dispenser to the left, and a sentry to the right. Now, I'm speeding things along by a second or two by hitting my quick switch bind to switch me to the same loadout I currently have. This is the equivalent of touching the resupply cabinet. However, the cabinet is so close to the spawn door in this situation that it barely even matters on this map. Now, during a long walk to the front, at some point, I hit my quick switch binds for the jag so that when I teleport myself back to spawn, I will instantly have the jag ready. Now, why did I place those buildings at the front? Well, it's for two reasons. I want them as close to an infinite ammo source as possible so that I can quickly upgrade the buildings, as well as allowing the dispenser to start building as quickly as possible. Normally, I'd be placing that dispenser at the front after I place my sentry gun. Now, remember, the dispenser takes 21 seconds to completely construct itself, so the later you put it down, the later it will become available for your teammates to start using. The dispenser is also the only building that actually gains something over time, metal supply. So right now, I have fully upgraded my sentry and my teleporter to level 3 with 10 seconds left. So at this point, I quickly switch back to the Eureka effect, grab my sentry gun, and take it through the teleporter. Immediately, I'll walk over to where I want to put it and teleport back to spawn. At this point, you can switch to whatever wrench you want. I chose to stick with the jag, and then I grab my dispenser and take it to the front as well.